Good evening, my name is Prince, this is Rubal, this is Akash. We have worked on the Scilab website. So what the Scilab website does is, there are two main features. One is textbook companion and one is lab migration. Lab migration proposes to migrate labs of different colleges which use MATLAB and Simulink for their experiments to use FOSS software, mainly Scilab and XCOS. So what happens, the process is simple. The teachers propose their labs with the desired experiments, and open source contributors provide code for the labs. And the another module is textbook companion. As you know, many technical textbooks have MATLAB solutions in them, or or give links in their websites, or provide MATLAB solutions for the questions, for the examples there on their websites, on the accompanying websites of the textbook. But we propose to provide Scilab examples for Scilab solutions for the textbook examples. So this website facilitates that. So we added features to that. The main problem was this website was earlier in Drupal 6. Okay, so and now it uses Drupal 7x core. And when it was converted from Drupal 6 to 7, there's a lot of scaffolding done, and this website was very unstable and the code was unformatted. So we had to deal with that, and we did our edits on that. Okay, now Akash will tell you about Textbook Companion.
So these are three modules that we have mainly worked on. So we have updated Textbook Companion and Lab Migration, and we have built User Dashboard. So User Dashboard module aims to provide user and admin to track the status of proposal more interactively for TBC and LM project. This module can be used in many other FOSSI websites supporting Drupal 7. It helps the user to view the current proposals, and it helps the admin to view all the status of all the proposals that exist. So these are some screenshots. I will be explaining this in a demo. So about Textbook Companion. So Textbook Companion aims to port solved examples from standard textbooks using open source software such as Scilab. Scilab is an open source version of MATLAB, and any AICT, non-AICT textbook can be used for this purpose. The objective of this Scilab textbook project is to create Scilab textbook companions to make it easy to users of such textbook to start using Scilab, which is free, to improve the documentation available for Scilab. Now I will show one video of how it works. So now user will log in, and it will click on textbook companion, and it will select the book that he wants to convert in Scilab. So from here he will select the book, and he will propose the book to the admin, that is Scilab team. So he will fill up this form detailing all the details of the book. So after filling the form is submitted, and the mail is gone to the admin suggesting that the user wants to propose a book to convert into Scilab. The admin will get the mail regarding that. We have just submitted the proposal that user wants to convert this particular book in the Scilab. So we have,
yes. We have submitted a proposal for.
Right now, the
submitted a proposal.
Just proposal. So now I'm logging in as an admin. So now admin will, so this is the interface that we have made for the admin. So you can see the pending proposal, all proposal, categorize, and failed proposal. So the pending proposal right now, the Akash Patil that I have made right now has arrived. So the admin will check all the details of the book, and it will approve from this action.
That Akash Patil says 16/8/2007. Yeah.
So that's a proposed date of completion, that he will be completing the book by that date. So after checking all the details, he will approve the proposal, and now
the proposal is from whom?
Proposal is from the user, the student.
Student or
why it needs to approval? If you take that book and convert
it. No sir, the
it works like this. There are certain requirements. So like some books are popular, so if the user can
no, if the student is saying I will take this book by Dr. Jolly. And I will convert it in this time.
Sir, who is anybody to ask? Sir, actually they get paid to do this. So
paid.
Yes, sir.
They get all of our money. Okay.
So
money.
So I think we have made another module which is currently under development. We have not deployed it yet. We will talk about that.
Okay. So after approving, user will start sending the codes.
Sending the
codes of the book. The solved examples that are in the book, it will be converted into Scilab. It will send to the site. So here we have made the dashboard that will show the current status of the user proposal, which was not implemented here till yet. And so user will select the code submission and start submitting the codes. So now the code submission previously was not so dynamic. It was hard coded mostly. So we have tried to make it more dynamic. So here user will upload these Scilab files, the dependencies, etc. So here you can see the whatever that user has uploaded right now, it will be displayed. This edit and delete was not there in previously. Sir, yes, this thing is already going on, but there was not the edit and delete option.
What is that you have?
Yes, sir. No, sir. Sir, actually, what happens was, if there was one error in the system that user by mistakenly submitted the wrong example in wrong chapter. So what happens was, he will call the Scilab team, and then Scilab team will go into the database and they will delete it. There was not like there was no
sending the proposal was already there.
Yes, sending proposals are there. So this thing, the main score submission was done by us.
And team was also there.
Yes.
You only had an edit and delete.
Sir, the thing was, most of this was there, but we have to make small changes. Like we were given orders from the Scilab team that we need this interface here, we need a text box here, we need a date picker here, and something like that. So we have to change that. We have to supply the interface as their requirements. If we had no control like what to do. We have to supply according to their requirements.
That's what we did.
Where is the list?
List. Tell us, and we have to.
So we had a task list. We got mailed a task list every day. Like these are the tasks you have to do, and we followed that.
Where is the list?
That's on our email.
But that is all you are present.
Yes, that's what we are presenting.
That's
presenting task submission, which is not part of the list.
Sir, we changed everything a little bit, but
if all you are done. Okay, he's taken an email, okay, and implemented the email. The email is your requirement, and you are not showing me the requirement.
Sir, these were the requirements. The interface.
This is not the requirement.
Sir, our main aim was to make more interactively the site.
No, you have told me already.
Yeah.
That your requirement was in a mail. You refused to show me the mail.
Yes.
So we can show you the mail if you want, but.
No, but that's. Shouldn't that be part of your presentation? This is our requirement.
So we are telling.
I don't know whether the mail. Okay, change the edit delete.
Sir,
from black to blue.
Sir,
that may be the only.
All the interface we are showing you are updated interface. These were.
I understand, but you are not telling me what you have done.
Sir, this table, like editing and deleting uploaded codes, was not.
Yes, no, but okay. Very early, you first said it's the editing.
Yeah.
Then you said we have done this.
Yeah.
Okay. Then you said I don't know what you have done. It is in the email.
So, sir, we are saying that you are telling that we did not change the whole interface. We edited specific features.
Yeah, I was a few minutes back.
Yeah.
Okay. Submission was done by you. You said no, we have not done it.
No, it was already.
Added the date picker. Okay.
Yes,
sir.
So why don't you tell me what you have done? Why did you ask that question?
Sir, the
proposal submission form did not look like that before. Okay, not look and the field. The fields there. We have to upload, add more tables in the database. Now more data is being fetched from the user, sir, let me first.
I think let them go ahead and. they are refusing to say what they have done. Let's assume that they have done.
So after completing all the, after submitting all the books, so user we click, I have submitted codes for all the examples, and the interface will be get
okay, locked. Okay, sir, this was a new feature. Earlier the user acknowledgement was not there. So what happened was, whenever the user submitted codes, after that the code interface did not get logged something. So the user sometimes deleted the codes after they uploaded, and like there are some blank files left. So we removed that. Now the code, the interface gets logged after the user uploads.
Certain person to whom I have to ask that question. Okay, are you doing something which was wrongly done by the previous batch of interns?
Yes.
Okay, then have you gone to their presentation and have they said this is future work?
Sir, this is not done by previous batch of work.
Then I will say okay, the interns are submitting code which is useless.
Sir, the.
I have to wait for 1 year.
No, sir. This
was not done by interns. It is a live website maintained by web admins.
The Scilab team,
the Fossi team.
Why did they not think of it? Because the web team, they have only, I think, three.
The Scilab team is on a shortage of web developers right now. If you go to the Scilab website, there's an ad for hiring web developers. So, what was the site?
Okay, doesn't matter. You continue. You keep saying whatever. I agree that you have done everything.
So, after completing the book and after checking all the codes, the status of the book will change by here by the admin, which will be under you for checking, and after checking it will be completed and it will be displayed in the completed tab, and now you can see your dashboard that the proposal has been completed. This is of TBC. Now Rupal will explain the lab migration. This is what we have done. We have completed.
So this is the lab migration module. I worked on this. So this is the common workflow. It's similar to the TBC module. And the areas and circles I worked on them. Upload code. Okay. So the earlier the code upload interface was such that for Scilab files, you know, they require sometimes signal processing files, they require audio files or something, or image processing files, they require images to work upon. So earlier what happened was, for every lab you had to upload different dependencies. Like there's this image processing people will know, there's this lena.jpg file, and it's used in most image processing experiments. Like it's very basic. So it had to be uploaded separately for every lab. But now you can select from existing dependencies, and just the database is updated, but the file remains same. So that saves space. Okay. Then in the code approval by admin. So this feature was added new. The admins earlier did not have a full view of all the codes and all the status of the codes. Now they have the view. Like they can see what the status of the code is, and they can assign new status to the code. Like they can approve or disapprove proposals, approve or disapprove solutions. Then there's this upload journal. This was requested. This feature was requested. The written lab journal in PDF format is uploaded. This was not earlier present. This was added. And these are the two new. You talked about money, sir. This is that part. So send forms by post. After the lab is the lab conversion over, the user sends an undertaking saying that he transfers his intellectual property to the Scilab team. He gives them the right to use their codes. That's some official documents. So there's this bridge between the account section and the user, which enables them to check the status of these dispatch documents and dispatch the checks accordingly. This is the interface that we have uploaded. Okay, so the accounting module is not yet completed. And another thing is, we are automating the testing of Scilab codes. When the Scilab codes get uploaded, right then and there, they're checked, they're executed on the server, and we are logging the output. If the output contains, like we are searching by a keyword error, if the output contains the word error, like the generic Scilab error, then the upload will be rejected at that moment. This will decrease the pressure on admins. We had to earlier review each and every code, but now they can just, the server will automatically do that. This has not been completely implemented, but we have made significant progress. That's it. Sir, we had to maintain and upgrade that Scilab website. The website had all unformatted code and no documentation.
Web development for Scilab. Optimization is
still optimized.
Thank you.